Men, to arms! Kill the assassins!
I would have liked to believe that they were strong enough to, like, handle the No, okay. Well, I know how I'm getting up, and I love how there's three options to get up. Let's do the fancy option. Because I need... Well, I'm gonna need some training. I mean, I could do the baby version. Alright. You know, I see that. You think a straight line would not be so hard, but apparently... It is. It is interesting how they made the original Assassin's Creed harder in terms of platforming compared to the recent ones, right? Like, platforming, like, hardcore took a backseat, right? Makes me wonder if they actually ever made it... If they went back and made parkour a little harder, it would be more.
It is good to see you unharmed.
Have more impact.
I trust your mission was a success.
Is the master in his tower?
Yes, yes, buried in his books as always. No doubt he expects you.
My thanks, brother.
Safety and peace out there.
On you as well.
Okay, so where is the man? Coming through. Oh, there we go. Wow. You know what? To be really fair, this was a, what, Gen 1 PS3 Xbox 360 title back in the day? This still looks pretty damn good, all things considered. Like, out of detail, how many NPCs are on the screen, the world design, the lighting. It still looks really good. I feel like I'm going away from where I need to go, but maybe I need to go away to go to the parkour hell of Uncharted 3. Oof. Well, to be fair, it does get a lot better with 4, though. Gentle push. Gentle push.
Ah, he returns at last.
Abbas.
Where are the others? Did you ride ahead hoping to be the first one back?
Not exactly.
You are loath to share the glory. Silence is just another form of ascent.
Have you nothing better
to do?
I bring word from the master. He waits for you in the library. Best hurry. No doubt you're eager to put your tongue to his boot.
Another word and I'll put my blade to your throat.
There'll be plenty of time for that later, brother.
There'll be plenty of time later for the fun. Safe word, boot. Love that part of Uncharted 3, but my brain stopped working last night and I couldn't figure out where I was supposed to go, so I put it down. See, now you know how I feel. Now imagine that, but on a daily basis. See, it does... I mean, if you look at the detail here, right? Barring the weird lighting going on and some of the weird graphical hiccups. Yeah, this still holds up really well. I'm trying to remember the story with Altair. The one thing I remember most about Assassin's Creed, other than the Ezio, like, seeing his story progress, was Connor in 3 being a big whiny pain in the butt. Altair being, like, the foundation. I think the only thing I remember is, like, Desmond getting screwed out, because if you've ever watched Troy Baker and Nolan North go through, like, the definitive Uncharted series or Last of Us series, and when you hear Nolan talk about Desmond, there's like this bitter pill that he's just like, yeah, I kind of hope that my character would have gone somewhere. Like, my character was being built up for this thing, and that just never happened. We never got to see like a future version or modern setting Assassin's Creed game. It's always, you know, history and bust. So, yeah. So I do remember one thing, and I played a little bit of each game to make sure that they all worked, right? When I started up Assassin's Creed 3, I kind of squealed with joy because it was John DeLancey, aka Q from Star Trek, and I completely forgotten that. Like, ow! I'd completely spaced that Desmond Miles' dad is Q. No matter what shade you throw at Assassin's Creed, you can't throw anything at that because that is Q. Q is awesome. Yeah. Ezio is your favorite? Really? Even over Ezio? Willow, morning.
Altair. Master. Come forward.
Yeah, I feel like I know that voice actor too. Oh, I got
it.
That is so weird when they're like, come forward. It's like, wait a minute, I actually have to move. They're very, like, they have cutscenes in this game, but it seems like they're very hesitant to, like, pull too much control out of the player. So, yeah. Hey, Ubi, do more of this. Yeah, like, when they say move forward, actually have the player move. Like, little, like, old school stuff, like, things like from, okay, I know, real tangent here. Back when I was playing MMOs, way back in the old days of like EverQuest 2, you had to like type in commands for the NPC to actually do something. And in my brain, I was just like, that's so cool. It's a command. It's a word command. I get it. But the idea that you had to do something like that, like sit down and actually have a beer with somebody before they're willing to talk to you. And then they'll just like repeat the dialogue, or they'll say something like, are you just going to stand there and do nothing? It adds a little bit of flavor. Yeah. He was also Discord in... Yes! He actually is. He's the only thing... Okay. I did a highlight reel of My Little Pony for just Discord because of John DeLancey. I'm not a My Little Pony fan, but hearing him as a villain was actually pretty cool.
Covered the Templar's treasure.
There was some trouble, Master. Robert de Sable was not alone.
When does our work ever go as expected? It's our ability to adapt that makes us who we are.
This time it was not enough.
What do you mean?
I have failed you.
The treasure?
Lost to us.
And Robert?
Escaped.
I send you, my best man, to complete a mission more important than any that has come before. And you return to me with nothing but apologies and excuses.
I did.
Do not speak! Not another word. This is not what I expected. We'll need to mount another force.
I swear to you I'll find him. I'll go in.
No! You'll do nothing. You've done enough. Where are Melek and Kadar?
Dead.
No! Not dead.
Melek?
I still live at least.
And your brother?
Gone. Because of you!
Robert threw me from the room. There was no way back. Nothing I could do.
Because you would not heed my warning! All of this could have been avoided! And my brother... My brother would still be alive! Your arrogance nearly cost us victory today.
Nearly?
I've what your favorite failed to find. Here. Take it. Though it seems I've returned with more than just their treasure.
Master, we are under attack. Robert de Sable lays siege to Masyaf's village.
So he seeks a battle. Very well. I'll not deny him. Go. Inform the others.
If you sip in moderation, Mr. Bruce, you're pretty much fine. Yeah. The game, main game run right now. Okay, so this is just the main games. Yes, so.
Make for the village. Destroy these invaders. Drive them from our home.
One, two, Brotherhood, Revelations, Black Flag, or Assassin's Creed 3, Black Flag, Origins, Odyssey. And for the record, out of all of them, Ezio series I'm looking forward to the most, mainly Revelation.
Altair, it's good you've come. We need your help.
What's happened?
Templars. They attacked the village. Most of our
people. Also Origins, just because it's Egyptian.
Most, but not all.
What do you need me to do?
Distract the Templars. Keep them occupied while I rescue those still trapped inside.
As you wish.
Let's get that killing spree. The D-pad, hidden blade, fist down, throwing knives, and sword. Okay. From what I remember, Assassin's Creed had a counter system that was a little on the broken side. Lock fight. Wait, use... Ah! Yeah, no, it's... Takes a little bit getting used to. Lock on. He survived so much. Oh, so if you hold it down.
With the coup de grace.
Blend in. Take my time. It's truly amazing here. See, I really, really, really feel like Ezio, out of all the video game characters I've ever played, Ezio had the most compelling narrative because he had three games at three different points of his life that just expanded on his character in such dynamic ways. And I remember really, really enjoying it. That's kind of what spurred this whole damn thing on, was like, well, is that nostalgia, like, bleeding through or what? Paul, hey, buddy. By doing all the ACs, we are doing AC 1, 2, Brotherhood, Revelations, Black Flag, 3, Origins, and Odyssey. So essentially main titles. I think Black Flag is the main one, but I'm throwing that in there because, well, to be fair, everybody and their mother says it's a really good game. We are skipping out on a few of the side ones like Syndicate and Unity because apparently there's no, like, connection. Yeah. And you for Geralt. Ain't nothing weird about it.
Fast forward in memory to a more recent one.
Wait, which one's Assassin's Creed 4? Was there a 4? Is that Flag?
Come. Al-Mu'alim's not done with us yet.
Black Flag, okay.
Up there. We've a surprise planned for our guests. Just do as I do. It should become clear soon enough.
I remember as a kid losing my mind. Actually, I should say teen losing my mind seeing this game, because the detail to, like, the major city, right? The first major city you go to was just like, okay. Also, this used to make me upchuck. The first couple times I had to do this, I was just like, "Whoop! Height, height."
Heretic! Write down what you have stolen from me.
You've no claim to it, Robert. Take yourself from here before I'm forced to thin your ranks further.
I just wish there were subtitles.
Yeah. Game.
I assure you, this is no game.
Also, nice touch for letting us choose where the camera goes. That is kind of cool.
Your village lays in ruins, and your stores are hardly endless. How long before your fortress crumbles from within? How disciplined will your men remain when the wells run dry and their food is gone?
My men do not fear death, Robert. They welcome it. And the rewards it brings.
Good. Then they shall have it all around.
Follow me, and do so without hesitation.
Show this fool knight what it is to have no fear. Go to God!
When you think about it, if you are a Templar and you see some dude jump off a ledge into what you could only describe as death, you should feel worried.
Oh, my leg!
Quiet, or the Templars will hear us.
Oh!
I'll stay behind and tend to him. You'll have to go ahead without us. The ropes there will bring you to a trap we've set. Go and release it. Rain death upon our enemies.
Ooh, let's go, chat. Now the detail... I'm still a little baffled, like, how well, Ubisoft did detail, like, the model for Ezio. Or, excuse me, Altair. Like, look at that. Ah, that looks so good. All right. Alio. Avalon. Due to this being a platformer game, 25 is tea time.
I'll stay behind and tend to him. You have to go ahead without us. The ropes there.
I forgot that the earlier versions of this game, when it comes to like parkour, it's a little more on the gotta be very careful. I see how they want me to climb it, but I thought he would like. Yes. So I was up all last night trying to actually get the death counter built, and I realized this has a very ugly UI scheme, so I gotta come up with something. Oh, okay, there we go. So don't... So if I... Oh, he'll just do it now automatically. Okay, there we go. Whoop! I am counting, though, so... Yeah, no, it is being counted. It's just I didn't have enough time to actually do a overlay or alerts yet. So I was trying to like theorycraft, come up. I was trying to find like a baseline between all the games that I could do. I mean, yes, it would be a desync, but I would like to believe that when you die, you kind of desync with life. You know what I mean?
Thank you.
His force is broken.
Thank you, Daddy.
It'll be a long while before he troubles us again. Tell me, do you know why it is you are successful? You listened. Were it that you'd listened in Solomon's temple, Altair, all of this would have been avoided.
I did as I was asked.
No, you did as you pleased. Malik has told me of the arrogance you displayed, your disregard for our ways.
What are you doing?
There are rules. We are nothing if we do not abide by the Assassin's Creed. Three simple tenets, which you seem to forget. I will remind you. First and foremost, stay your blade.
From the flesh of an innocent, I know.
And stay your tongue, unless I give you leave to use it. If you are so familiar with this tenet, then why did you kill the old man inside the temple? He was innocent. He did not need to die. Your insolence knows no bounds. Make humble your heart, child, or I swear I'll tear it from you with my own hands. The second tenet is that
we do not mess with Master Splinter.
Hide in plain sight. Let the people mask you such that you become one with the crowd. Do you remember? Because as I hear it, you chose to expose yourself, drawing attention before you'd struck. The third and final tenet, the worst of all your betrayals. Never compromise the Brotherhood. Its meaning should be obvious. Your actions must never bring harm upon us, direct or indirect. Yet your selfish act beneath Jerusalem placed us all in danger. Worse still, you brought the enemy to our home. Every man we've lost today was lost because of you.
I'm sorry.
Technically, that last one would be the other guy, right?
But I cannot abide a traitor.
Thank you, Song, directly to you. Oh, thank you.
A traitor.
Your actions indicate otherwise. And so you leave me no choice. Peace be upon you, Altair.
Oh!
He's experiencing a far better adoption rate than the other subjects.
I'm still pulling him out. He's been in there way too long.
No, not yet. We're still so far from where we need to be.
We shouldn't risk it.
What's another hour or two?
Why don't we discuss this in the conference room? Give Desmond a minute to stretch his legs.
I really don't see the need.
Warren, please.
I really don't see.
Fine.
He's a guinea pig. We were gonna turn him into a potato. Come on. Hang on. Unless the old man is using us as a an out, right? If you will.
Eight lips, chat.
Okay. While they're doing that, I'm gonna. Do I have eagle vision? Anything? No. Very Spartan. Wait a minute, what was that? Press the... Hello?
I don't appreciate your questioning my authority in front of the prisoner. There's a word for that. I believe it's called insubordination.
And I don't appreciate you trying to kill him. There's a word for that too. I believe it's called stupid.
Lucy, this isn't my decision. I don't have
to mind,
but I'm smart enough not to challenge. Do you want to wind up like Layla?
I know the accident has everyone on edge.
Which is why there's no time to coddle him.
If you push him too hard, he'll shut down. And then we'll have nothing.
We have nothing now.
But we will. You just need to have a little faith.
Fine. But I want you thinking of ways to improve his staying power. We can't afford to stop every time the man breaks a sweat. It's bad enough we have to traipse through all of these
useless memories.
I'll do what I can. Yeah, mine was 16 this morning. They were terrible. They coming out? Yeah, they're coming out. All right. We're going back in, Doc.
When
We're done for today, Mr. Miles. I suggest you return to your room and get some rest.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. See, I listen like a good little boy, and they lock
the
door.
Lock the door.
Well, I guess they can't exactly trust me, so, you know. Good on them. The following morning.
Gotta say, that's a little creepy, Doc. Waking up to you standing over me. You been watching me sleep?
We're always watching you. Now get up. We've got a lot of work to do.
Ooh, wonder who I get to kill today.
Don't be so cavalier. Your ancestors almost had the right idea, Mr. Miles. If the deaths of a few people, evil people, no less, could save the lives of thousands more, well, it seems a small sacrifice.
What do you mean, almost?
They didn't go far enough. To use a rather tired analogy, corruption is no different than cancer. Cut out the tumors, but fail to treat the source and... well, you're buying time at best. There's no true change to be had without comprehensive, systemic intervention.
Chemo for the masses.
Education. Re-education, to be more precise. But it's not easy, and it doesn't always take.
Let me guess. You've got a better solution. What is it, then?
Now that would be telling.
He actually believes they're doing the right thing. I completely, like, for whatever reason, I got in my mind that, like, the Templars were, like, super duper bad guys. Like, comically evil bad guys. And that, you know, there wasn't, like, people in the organization who were like, yeah, no, we're doing this because we have to do this. Some of the things we're doing are bad, but on the same side, it's going to help out billions, if not future billions. Continue from latest memory. All right.
Selecting the hidden blade during fight will allow you to quickly dispatch.
I am alive.
But I saw you. That's a good feeling.
Felt death's embrace.
I remember the load times in this game used to be like 2 minutes on the PS3, 3 minutes tops.
Sleep of the dead, of the womb, that you might awake and be reborn.
To what end?
Do you remember, Altair, what it is the assassin fight for?
Peace. In all things.
Yes, in all things. It is not enough to end the violence one man commits upon another.
Is there any way to, like, tone down that audio? Music right there? Yes. Okay, I'm gonna drop that down a smidge.
It refers to peace within as well. Cannot have one without the other.
So it is said.
So it is. But you, my son, have not found inner peace. It manifests in ugly ways. You are arrogant and overconfident.
Were you not the one to say that nothing is true and everything is permitted?
You do not understand the true meaning of the phrase, my child. It does not grant you the freedom to do as you wish. It is a knowledge meant to guide your senses. It expects a wisdom you clearly lack.
Then what is to become of me?
I should kill you for the pain you've brought upon us. Malik thinks it only fair. Your life in exchange for his brother's. But this would be a waste of my time and your talents. You'll see you have been stripped of your possessions. Your rank as well. You're a novice. A child once more. As you were on the day you first joined our order. I'm offering you a chance at redemption. You'll earn your way back into the Brotherhood.
I assume you've something planned.
First, you must prove to me you remember how to be an assassin.
So you'd have me take a life?
No,